Asa, this has been brewing in me for a long time, man. And I knew that I had to make this video to you because I feel for such a long time now, you have just taken advantage of this friendship and you don't truly respect me or value me for things I've done and I've helped you with. A little you might know that Asa actually started monetizing back on his channel again. And that was all because of me. Asa's IP was blocked at his house. He came over here and I got this fucking monetization. I have completely lost a lot of respect for him over this whole Encyclopedia Dramatica fucking drama thing and just things I know about Asa in real life. And Asa has a real misconception that the world revolves around him. And I've been used as a pawn in his game to attack people and stuff like that. And I really started to realize, you know, he doesn't need me or call me or even want to really hang out or anything unless he's making a video or he has some type of agenda that I fit into. And that's not friendship. Asa loves this. He loves the drama. He loves what's happening. He's going to sit there and tell you that it's horrible what's going on in my family, this and that and everything else. But the simple fact of the matter is, he wouldn't have made a video about it if he fucking didn't love it. Eric, you've posted so many private things to your Facebook that anybody can just waltz on and see. Dude, you posted stuff about your daughter's first day of school. You posted trouble that you were having with your wife. And then you turn around and say, people are fucking picking on me. People are doing this and that. Asa, you make things readily available for these people to have ammunition against you. And you tend not to recognize that. And it's such bullshit, man. I know you're smarter than that. I don't buy into any of these things that you don't want this. You want all this. And I'm quite fucking sure of it. Man, I've lost so much respect for you. It's fucking crazy to me. You've made your bed. Now you need to sleep in it. Because, man, all this drama, all this bullshit, all it's gonna do is push people like me who've truly helped you away. Because, man, I don't want nothing to do with this crap. But people should clearly be able to tell by me making this video that you do have some serious fucking issues, Eric. That you need to address, and you need to fucking change. I'm done with this. I have nothing else to say. So until next time, dear viewer.
11:08 a.m.
Hey Kyle, you really should answer your phone. This is Eric. I really want to know why you've been doing this to me. I never did anything to deserve the treatment I'm getting from you. And I think I owed an apology from you. If you're a man, you should answer the phone. And if you're not, you can continue being the weaselly little shit you've been. Come on, man. Answer the phone. For once in your goddamn life, be a man and confront your people face to face. Don't make me come on down there and force it out of you.
Punching your door! Ugh.
see how threatening I am?
Please stop doing that.
Okay, but I just wanted you to know that I could do that.
Dude, why are you covering your mouth?
Because I don't want you to be able to identify me by my voice.
But I can identify you by your face.
Ah, now you can't identify me.
Would you like to come in and maybe talk about this?
Yeah.
So, have a seat, man.
Okay.
So, do you stalk people on a regular basis? Actually, how did you find my address?
Well, I'm glad you asked that. You see, one day I was online and I saw this video by a man named M. Ravel, who told me that I should kill you because of all your past transgressions against gamers. And so, well, I'm here to kill you and your family and burn your house down.
Will you stop using that voice?
Okay. Oh, thank you. I was parched.
So, why are you doing this, and why do you hate me so much? Please take that cap off.
Okay, so, what I don't get is why do you hate my-
That old video?
Yes, that video!
I made that a year ago. I haven't even made a video since then. I retired. In fact, I have to go to my badminton league in about 20 minutes, so can we get this over with?
Okay, so what's gonna happen is probably someday I'm gonna kill you, strangle your children, probably kill your dog too.
Yeah, about that. I called the authorities. They're gonna be here in a few minutes. So you can either, you know, run or, you know, stay and tell your side of the story. Whatever you choose to do, it really doesn't matter to me.
Why would you do that? I just wanna kill you. You made a video I hate.
Well, you did threaten me and the life of my children. I'm sorry, I had to do it. So, you know. No.
It was Emmerville's fault. It was Emmerville. He brought me here. It's his fault. He told me to come here and kill you. Just.
And this is exactly how I dealt with this little problem of mine. Yep, this is exactly how it happened.
We know you're in there. Come out with your hands up.
Hello, I'm Asalieri, and since its very creation, the internet has opened its doors to so many possibilities.
Jobs, entertainment, forums, the social media, the internet has no doubt changed the world. And yeah, because of its immersive nature of allowing complete anonymity to people, some have inevitably turned to abusing other people online for their own entertainment. This does not invalidate the positive uses of the internet, however.
Feeding into this negativity will not make you truly any happier, and why insult people who are clearly just trying to rile you up when you can allow us to inject some positivity into their lives? Kyle and Asa proudly present Empathy.
Video responses for when you just want to say something nice to someone but don't quite know how after so many years of the internet teaching you otherwise. We have videos for people who've lost hope in humanity. People who are fed up with the world.
Fuck this world. Fuck this world.
I respect you immensely for having the guts to say it.
Oh, that's awful nice of you.
Videos for people who just need to be reminded how cool they are deep down inside.
Locate them right here on my channel and start using them today, because, by God, don't you think it's about time someone said something nice for a change?
And if you're gonna limit yourself to answering with a video quip rather than attempting to have reasoned debate, you may as well spread some kind words around rather than just continue the cycle of antagonizing.
Right? Yeah. Wow, dude. You know, you're lucky that it's my day off today and I have all the time in the world, man. But you know what we need? Let me get a friend. I think we need a third opinion on this. Yo, Kyle, come over here, man.
What's going on, man?
Check out what this guy's got to say.
Hey, what's going on?
So fucking cool. Hey. Hey, hell on, dude. Grab a beer.
Oh, yeah, man.
Hell's yeah, man.
Hell yeah.
Fuck yeah, dude.
Yeah.
Fuck yeah.
To you, buddy.
Hell yeah. You go ahead and grab one, too, man.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah, that's fucking cool, dude.
Oh, yeah.
Hell yeah, man.
You couldn't be any more right on. Shit.
Dude, me too, man. Dude, we totally need to do that next time.
I agree.
Fuck yeah.
Absolutely.
Holy shit, what you just said completely blew my mind. And though I disagree with you, I respect you immensely for having the guts to say it. You know, next time we potentially disagree on a subject, I would really like to hear your opinion on it. And hell, I'd like to find out what kind of things we have in common. I hope you don't find it too disrespectful, but I'd really like to shake your hand.